Okay, so here are the cores there. The top left corner, we have the suggested inversions, and the first chord is an F in root position, and that is the first chord of the song as well. So you're going to play left hand, F in root position. The next chord, you're going to play E flat in first inversion. So you're going to go up, like so. G, B flat, E flat, and then G in root position. And C in second inversion. So let's play those four chords once again. So two beats per chord for the first chord for F, and then one beat each to get to the C. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, one. One more time. So we have F, one, two, ready, go. One, two, E flat, G, C. Let's loop that just so that one more time, a little slower. Ready, and one, two. Then from there, the next chord is an E minor, and you see how it says E minor slash G, so let's just say that the G is the lowest note on that chord. So the inversion is written in that way. And then we have E diminished, right? So let's figure out how to find E diminished. So E with the circle is an E diminished. So here's E major, right? Here's E minor. Diminished, you come from the minor and you flat the fifth. And that's E diminished. But on the song, it says E diminished slash G, so we want the lowest note to be G. So I'm going to take this E and play an octave higher. So that's that chord. Sounds really horrible. Sounds very dissonant, right? So check it out. Let's go again from the C chord. So C was here, right? And look what happens. To the next chord, what happens is that the C goes down to the B, and that makes the E minor. The next chord, that B goes down to B flat, and that makes it into the E diminished. So it's like that inner voice moving downwards by half a step. So let's go from the beginning of the song again. I'll play both hands, and you can choose to do just the left if you want. One, two, three, four. Continue just the left hand second line, A minor in root position, going to D major in second inversion, going to G in root position. So let's do that again. Measure 5, A minor, going to D with the pinky staying in the same place, G root position. Then for A minor, we go back to A minor root position. Now we have a very different chord there. We have A flat plus that is augmented. So to find an augmented chord, first you find a major. And then you sharp the fifth. That's augmented. So basically, you're coming from A minor. So to get to A flat augmented, you just move that pinky down. And then the next chord is a C slash G. And now it's a D, and check it out, it's saying first above it. That's saying, oh, let's play that D with first inversion. And then it goes to the F, E flat again, and back to the beginning. All right, let's play from the beginning. I'll play both hands. You can play just the left if you want, or hands together. One, two, three, four. Two, three, four. continue to show you have this in video. So check it out. Second part of the song, we have A major on the left hand. Straight to the coda. Yeah? Make sense? Alrighty. That's all.